What is up, everybody? I am Knight, Chris Knight, and this is The Real Review 3000, here with another weekly wrap-up. And, you know, looking back on this, is, I think, number seven. Seven. That means 28 videos, 35 if you count these. And that's a big milestone. I mean, when you think back on it, I'm like sitting here going, like, how long have I been doing five videos a week? Quite a bit. And I'm thankful that all of you guys have been helping me out, watching them, commenting. Thank you so very much. I appreciate every last one of you. Let's get right to it. Sunday, we had the Mandalorian Roundtable, as always. So we had Bear Bear, Nerd Fun, Mike Rogers, Steeg, Shellback TJC, Sporking News Podcast, and Comics Division on. We talked about how the Mandalorian is running out of time to get to the point, and how several of us are doubting if they can even come up with a satisfying conclusion to the season in that time. So, you know, it's getting kind of down to crunch time for the Mandalorian. Monday, it was day one of our Bond week with the Bond Equation Part 1. We talked about Lashana Lynch and how she could be getting her own spinoff in the Bond universe. And I was like, whatever, because I don't think it's going to last. I don't think that's going to go very far, because people just don't want to see, in my opinion, people don't want to see a female character like Bond in the Bond universe, unless they're just a part in the movie. If they're a secondary part in the movie, I think people are okay with it. And I even said, I'm okay if she continues her part in the universe in the Bond movies, but I don't think she's going to last very long if they do a spinoff series. We also had The Gospel According to Chris, and this week we had the other half of The Real Review 3000, Sean Stackhouse, from Sean Stackhouse Reacts. We continued our discussion from the Wonder Woman 84 trailer and the Ghostbusters Afterlife trailer. I did a reaction with him on both of those over on his channel. Go check that out. And, you know, it's always a good time when Sean and I get to stream together, so I was glad we got to do that. We don't do it that often over here. This is his channel as much as it is mine, but he does a lot of stuff over on his channel, so when we get the time to do stuff over here, it's a really good time, I think. Now, Tuesday, on the Bond Equation Part 2, we listed out the long list of people who could play Bond next. To our surprise, Lashana Lynch wasn't the only woman on that list. There was like four or five altogether, and the more I look into this, there's like seven or eight names out there that are female. But just remember, you know, Barbara Broccoli said that Bond would not be played by a woman. This is a woman saying that, so don't say I'm sexist. It's just how it is. We also named our four main picks for who we would like to see play Bond next. So, on Wednesday, the Bond Equation Part 3, we talked about two of those picks, Henry Cavill and Tom Hiddleston, and their chances of becoming Bond. We talked about the whys, the why nots, with a few interesting facts about both of them. Go check that out. Just interesting facts, especially the Henry Cavill one I throw out there. Most people don't seem to know that. I didn't realize that, but I give out a really interesting fact about that that might help his chances in becoming the next Bond. Now, Wednesday. Wednesday, we were also on a live stream with Thomas Gilkey. I think I've popped into a few of them this week, but this was an actual scheduled one. Thomas Gilkey did another deep stream, which are always really fun to do. Great discussions on those. We talked about love and reaching out to others, and that's something that he's really good at, is reaching out to others. So I was glad to be on that stream with him. I always enjoy his streams, and I always appreciate his invitation to be on those streams. So Thomas, thank you very much. Go check that out on his channel as long as it's up. Now, Thursday, we wrapped up our Bond week with the Bond Equation Part 4, and basically we had the two people were Idris Elba and Aiden Turner, and we gave some good reasons for both, including the fact that Barbara Broccoli has said recently that the time is now for a non-white Bond. And I gave my pick to who I thought should be the next Bond, but you're going to have to go watch that video to find out who I thought should be the next Bond. I'm not going to tell it to you on here. I'm not going to give away all my secrets. Now, with that said, I want to thank all of you who have helped me eclipse the 600 sub mark, which we just did the other day. Next week, we'll be doing our mega halfway to pay, halfway to hashtag PandaSuitMary celebration stream. So check out that. I'll put something up on Twitter about that. I hope to have a bunch of people over for that. But with that said, do me a favor. Put down in the comments below what you like the most about the Bond equation and who you think is going to be the next Bond. Tell me down there in the comments. With that said, smash that like button. Hit the bell so you know when we're coming out with new stuff. And if you haven't subbed, please consider it. If you have, if you can pass our name along and let people come over here and see our content, and hopefully they'll sub too, we greatly appreciate that. Appreciate every last one of you. Thank you very much. I am Chris Knight. This is The Real Review 3000, and I'm officially out of here.
Hey guys, thanks for checking us out. Be sure to subscribe to both channels, and make sure to check out our friends in the Fandom Minutes. You can find us on YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and BitChute. And you can also send us an email at sean@seanstackhousereacts.com and chrisknight@therealreview3000.com. And be sure to swing by our Teespring store to pick up some awesome merchandise.